Thank you. Welcome candidates, faculty, parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, family, and friends to the 46th commencement of Friendship Christian School. These graduate candidates have achieved their goals and set school records. They have demonstrated leadership to their classmates and younger students. They have engaged in acts of service and have been witnesses for Jesus Christ in this community and around the world. Therefore, it is my privilege on behalf of the Board of Directors of Friendship Christian School to be the first to congratulate you and your families on this, your graduation day. We want to begin this afternoon by asking God to bless this occasion. And at this time, I would like to invite Dr. Jonathan Richardson, father of graduate candidate Emily Richardson, to the platform to lead us in our invocation.
Good afternoon. I am not Jonathan Richardson. I am Kevin Lester, and I am currently the chairman of the board. And let me be the second person to congratulate this class. We really are appreciative of the time you've been at Friendship, and we're going to have a great celebration. But before we move into the graduation celebration, I wanted to make a special surprise presentation for just a minute, and then we'll move into the regular agenda. John, would you stand up and join me for a sec? This is a special year for Mr. John Shoulders, our president and CEO of the school. He is completing his 20th year as head of school. And the board wanted to thank him in front of 1,000 people, if we could, tell him how much we appreciate him and for the time that he's been at the school. And we wanted to do it in front of people who love the school or know somebody or have somebody at the school that they love. So, John, let me speak about you for just a minute. He's a visionary. He's energetic, he's bold, he's collaborative, he's decisive, he's a builder, a shaker, and a mover. And I'm not going to bore you with some data like our debt's 3 times less than it was when he came, and the value of our institution's 3 times greater than it was at the time. I won't bore you with the fact that fundraising now can be used for cool things for the school and not lights and toilet paper and things that it used to have to go for. Instead, let me tell you about John and Pam, his very capable and equally talented spouse, how much they love God and his message of redemption, number one, and number two, their passion about serving young people. Together, FCS has been their joint place of ministry. And there's really no tougher or higher calling than to make your living serving and being with the most important thing in someone else's life, and that's their children. And his team, administrative team, faculty and staff that have been with him for quite some time, make it their mission every day, knowing that it's your children that they're serving. So for 20 years, daily, John and Pam have infused their love of God and their love of young people into this academic institution. Students, when they're here, they have an opportunity to serve. They leave here prepared to excel at their next challenge, taking with them a worldview shaped by having experienced Christ and his mission to redeem. And this is what makes John and Pam successful for the last 20 years, being the head of our school. So, we wanted to tell you so in person, that we love you and we thank you. Got him some commemorative things. I have a plaque here. It's got his name on it. John Shoulders, 20 years of dedicated leadership, Friendship Christian School, July 1, 2022. His first day was 2002, July 1. Also, we have a little pocket watch that has our insignia, sailboat insignia, and also the date and the congratulations. So we're going to get on with the rest of the party. So thank you for letting me surprise him and interrupt this for just a moment. Thank you very much, John. Good job. You may have a word, and then Jonathan will come.
All right. Jonathan, as you make your way here, I just want you to know that Sir Isaac Newton says, if I can see further than most, it's because I've stood on the shoulder of giants. And those giants, some of them were already here, like Randall Dunn and John McNeil and Christy Chaffin, who were here when I came. And for the last 19 years, this sweet lady here, Veronica, and her right hand, Jason Miller, have been doing this together. And then as time went on, we had Mark Strickland and Aaron Sane and Kimberly Toon joined our team in the administrative side. And these incredible faculty, I can't thank you enough. In my heart, for my wonderful wife and children, Kristen and Luke and Jake, and the time that they've sacrificed many times on vacations as I was on the phone dealing with school business, I am so thankful for each one of you. And there's no greater joy to me than to celebrate 20 years of having incredible students like these that will graduate today. Thank you. God bless you.
Mr. President, I want to be the first to personally congratulate you and thank you for 20 years of service to this fine school. God bless you. Well, as I look at these graduates today, I am reminded of the number of them that through the years that I've had a personal investment and connection with. I have memories and stories over the years because of the relationship that they've shared with me and with my wife and my daughter. But standing here, when I look around this room, I realize that the number of you that have personally invested in my daughter, and as a husband of a faculty member and a parent of a graduate, this has been a great adventure. But we all know that we have not been on this adventure alone. So on behalf of all the parents, I want to say thank you. To the faculty, the administration, the coaches, and the workers who come in early and stay late, all of you who took the time to do something, either in your job description or not, that made our children's life a little bit more enjoyable while they've been here. Whether you realize it at the time or not, you made a difference. And in just a few months, there will be another group of seniors that you will take on. You will repeat what you do from August to May, and many of you during the summer. But I want you to know that what might be routine to you meant the world to us as parents. I noticed. We all noticed. And we'll remember you guys. Thank you. Let's pray. Lord, we realize that some of the most meaningful blessings in life are temporary. We have but a season to invest and enjoy, and sometimes we don't realize until it's almost too late. For the blessings of raising our children, Lord, we say thank you, and thank you that along the way at this school, we had those reminders of how brief our time would be, and we were told to make the most of it. From kindergarten, graduation, to trips to the zoo, to those elementary performances, to the middle school trips, high school sports, chapel time, after school extracurricular activities, they were all reminders of the very moment that we are experiencing was always right at our doorstep. And now that we're here, thank you, Lord. Thank you that we're not standing here alone. thank you that as we prepare to release our most precious treasures out into the world, that we realize that they were just on loan to us. We pray, Lord, that we will be found good and faithful stewards of the life that you entrusted us with. We are thankful for the help that we have received along the way. Thank you for Friendship Christian School, for the leaders, the faculty, the coaches, and the staff. May you continue to bless them in the generations to come. For the grandparents and the family who have attended performances, sporting events, and fundraisers. For those who volunteered their time to allow our children to experience some of the fun things in life. For those who worked at concession stands, at a gate, or a door to a performance. Thank you, Lord, for using them to make our lives a little easier and more enjoyable. And as I pray to you on behalf of all the other parents, I ask that you bless those workers and those families that have helped us because they gave of themselves for our children. Our Father, we pray your continued blessings on these graduates. Let them, as they have always done so here, work to their greatest abilities. Let them continue to use the skills that they have gained here to conquer and bless the world set before them. And after today, we might not be able to see them as often as we like. Remind them in their hearts that we will always be with them in prayer and in spirit. And in our minds, we will always hear those words from Friday night with a smile. Come on, show your colors, Friendship. Green and gold. And as they show their colors in the days to come, let them paint our world with the spirit of pride, respect, and love that they have learned here. For your glory, our Father, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
The salutatorian is gifted athletically, artistically, and intellectually. With a 30 ACT, she is a recipient of the Presidential Scholarship to Tennessee Tech and the Hope Scholarship. She is a star in her art classes and has played volleyball and tennis for FCS. However, her most compelling trait is her compassion for others. Ellen has helped provide food and clean water in Sneeville, Tennessee, and volunteered at her church throughout her entire high school career. Her compassion for others extends to her career choice, as she is planning to be a speech pathologist after college. She embodies her favorite scripture, which is Romans 12:21. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Miss Ellen Williamson, our salutatorian for our 21-22 FCS school year.
Thank you, Ms. Bender. Hi, everyone. I want to welcome you again to the graduation of the class of 2022. I appreciate you all for taking the time to celebrate with us today. When I reflect over the past 4 years at Friendship, I remember what I won't miss about high school. Doing my stats project in one night wasn't my best idea. Never taking the ACT again definitely makes the list. And I never want to see one of Mr. Link's Scantrons ever again. But then, I remember everything I will miss. I'll miss getting coffee with my brother before school, eating lunch with my friends on half days, and art class with Mrs. Duckweiler. I have learned so much academically, emotionally, and spiritually throughout my high school career. I feel blessed to have gone to a school where the teachers make an effort to have a relationship with their students. I consider many of my teachers friends and mentors. I will forever cherish the friendship I have with my best friends. A wise man once said, "If you've got five real friends, then you've had a great life." I am privileged to have found that so early in my life. Emma, Maddie, Brooks, Kylie, and Tyler are unbelievably talented, funny, and kind people. They have made the past 4 years so much fun, and I know I'll be able to rely on them long after high school. I want to thank my mom and dad for everything that they've done for me. My parents are extremely special to me, and all I have ever wanted to do is make them proud. They're my role models, and I love them very much. While I have enjoyed all my years at Friendship, senior year has been my favorite. This year, I got out of my comfort zone and got to know people I probably wouldn't have gotten the chance to talk to otherwise. I have also grown closer to my classmates, and I will truly miss you all. The best word to describe today is bittersweet. Today, we close a chapter of our lives and celebrate our accomplishments. We worked hard to get here, and we should be proud of ourselves. I am so excited to see what God has planned for you all. Thank you again, teachers, faculty, family, and friends, for joining us on this special day. In one way or another, you have impacted our lives, and we are so grateful. Thank you.
Thank you, Ellen. This year's valedictorian is one of the most tenacious students I have ever met. Her dedication to her education has resulted in an ACT score of 31. She is a recipient of the Presidential Scholarship to attend Tennessee Tech and also the Hope Scholarship. She has played volleyball throughout high school. Her faith in Christ and desire to serve others are evident in her mission while at attending FCS. She fed people without housing in Nashville regularly, helped provide food and clean water to individuals in Sneeville, Tennessee, and tutored students throughout her time as a high school student. While Psalms 46:5 is referring to Israel, it could also be speaking of AZ. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. At this time, I would like to present to you Ms. AZ Dixner, our 21-22 valedictorian.
Thank you, Ms. Bender. Hello, everyone. I'm so thankful to have all of you here as we celebrate this special moment in our lives. If you don't know me, I'm AZ Dixner, and I have been at Friendship Christian for 14 years. So when I found out I'd be given the opportunity of speaking today, I struggled to find the words. You can ask my friends, my teacher, or Ms. Bender, because I definitely turned this very speech in over a month late. What do you say to the people, the mentors, and the school that has raised you for the past 14 years before you strike off on your new beginning? Do you speak about the good times, the hard times, or do you attempt to give words of wisdom? I remember thinking, I'm 18 and I struggle to find ketchup in the grocery store. How am I supposed to give wisdom to a whole class on how to take on this new dividing chapter in life? So obviously I chose the wisdom route. I began my writing by Googling inspiring quotes, and I came across a very inspiring, wise, but often overlooked, influential figure. He said, "If ever there is a tomorrow when we're not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you feel, and smarter than you think." Winnie the Pooh. I don't know about y'all, but thinking about the path ahead can be very nerve-wracking at times. I often worry about measuring up, making the good grades, finding the right job, and overall, anxiously pondering if I will succeed. That can be debilitating if you let it, but as Winnie the Pooh said, you are braver than you believe. No matter how nervous you may be about this next step, you all have the bravery and courage needed to push through. I've witnessed it myself. There are also many challenges that await us in this next chapter of life. We will face obstacles that seem impossible to overcome and mountains that seem too hard to climb. There will be times when we feel weak and unable to complete this course, but you are stronger than you feel. And as we go on to higher learning, whether it be college, trade school, or being on the job, we are bound to come across new and difficult problems that we must solve. We will have to put in longer hours, greater effort, and deeper thought. The solutions will seem out of reach, but you are all smarter than you think. So my parting advice is don't waste your time underestimating yourself and your abilities. It's easy to get caught up in the self-doubt and limit yourself from the infinite possibilities. However, if you go into each situation believing you are capable and properly equipped, you could just find that you can reach even farther than the stars. The days seem long, but the years will be short. Find a reason to enjoy every moment. And thank you to every one of you, here and not here, that have gotten us to this moment. Congratulations, class of 2022.
It has often been said that life is not measured by the breaths that we take, but by the moments that take our breath away. In 2010, former friendship teacher and counselor Kate Kinzer gave birth to two beautiful children. And although John and Hallie's breaths were limited, their impact was significant. Their parents, Kate and Reagan Kinzer, desired to preserve their memory and spirit, and so established the John and Hallie Kinzer Memorial Scholarships. Each year, at the Kinzer's request, a committee of faculty selects graduating seniors that have exhibited the characteristics of faithfulness and dependence upon God. It is our pleasure this afternoon, on behalf of the Kinzers, to present the John and Hallie Kinzer Memorial Scholarship to two worthy recipients, Miss Alex Fakes and Mr. Hayden Potts. Please congratulate them as they come to the platform. The Disciple of Christ Award is presented annually to two FCS graduating seniors who best reflect Christ in their daily lives through servanthood, humility, and positively influencing others for Christ. This year, an anonymous donor has generously established the 1-316 scholarship in the amount of $1,316 for each of the Disciple of Christ recipients over the next four graduating classes. The significance of this amount is found in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. This award emphasizes the fact that there is only one Christ in which salvation can be found. It is our privilege this afternoon to present the first annual 1-316 scholarship to this year's Disciple of Christ recipients, Ms. Sloan Stewart and Mr. Zachary Elliott. Please congratulate them as they make their way to the platform. Each year, we are also blessed to give the Spirit of Friendship Award. It is given to the student that best exemplifies the passage in Luke 2:52, and Jesus grew in wisdom and in stature and favor with God and men. This medallion has always been given anonymously until a few years ago when one of our founding board members passed away. It was this board member who had provided each of the gold medallions and made it possible to honor one of our graduating seniors in this special way. Since his passing, his family has graciously allowed us to call this award the Eddie Evans Spirit of Friendship Award. We are pleased to honor Miss Emily Richardson as the recipient of the 2022 Eddie Evans Spirit of Friendship Award. Let's congratulate her as she makes her way to the platform. The class that you see before you, the class of 2022, has distinguished itself in numerous ways during their years at Friendship Christian School, and I'd like to share just a few of these with you at this time. These seniors will be attending 16 different institutions of higher education, and 96% of them will be heading to an institution of higher learning. 20 of these 50 graduates received combined total scholarship offerings of more than $100,000 each. The class of 2022 has been offered a total scholarship amount of $4,373,460. What is more exciting than this figure is what they will accept and receive to use this next fall, a total of $2,362,880. That means, on average, each student will be using more than $47,000. The class of 2022 has not only distinguished itself in the classroom, but also in athletics. With their leadership and athletic ability, this class has led the girls' bowling team in winning Friendship's first ever state championship in girls' bowling, and continued their dominance with two sets of back-to-back state championships, becoming the first sport in FCS history to win four state championship rings. More important than these accomplishments, this class has given of their lives in serving others locally and regionally. Locally, as a class, they have helped serve hundreds of meals to the homeless and have served selflessly in dozens of ways in our community. This class has also ministered regionally by initiating numerous outreaches and taking dozens of trips to the town of Sneedville, Tennessee, in Hancock County, one of the poorest areas in the United States. This is truly an outstanding class of students for their achievement in the classroom, as athletes, and as servants of Christ endeavoring to meet the needs of a lost world. It is now my distinct honor to present to you the Friendship Christian School Class of 2022. Please join me in congratulating them on their accomplishments.
These candidates have completed all of the requirements set forth for graduation. By the power vested in me by the state of Tennessee, Cognia Accreditation, and the Board of Directors of Friendship Christian School, it is my honor and privilege to confer upon these candidates their high school diplomas, entitling them to all the honors, rights, and privileges pertaining. Kristen Bien Alverson, with honors. Lainey Michelle Bentley. Emma Elizabeth Blair. Jackson Whitmore Bone. Adam David Brooks. Daniel Kyle Burris, with honors. Emma Grace Cottle. William Thomas Collier, with honors. Brody Gary Cooper. Bryn Violet Cooper. Casey Lee Cottrell, with honors. Emma Grace Cresilius, with honors. Seth Britton Cron with honors. Gabriel Alexander Deffendall. AZ Renee Dixner with honors. Max Robert Duckwaller with honors. Logan Alexander Elliott. Zachary Thomas Elliott. Catherine Alexis Fakes. George Lee Theodore Howard. Liana Hope Ilias. Dylan Ray Johnson. Casey Thomas Jones. John Paul Kane. Jawan Walat Kapan with honors. Grace Olivia Carstens with honors. Carson Michael Kennedy with honors. Madison Elizabeth McLean. Leon Morgan McGregor. Elizabeth Ann Miller. Mackenzie Nicole Miller. Ethan Thomas Olivier. Chloe Glenn Parrish. Travis Isaac Patterson. Hayden Ford Potts with honors. Matty Claire Purcell with honors. Emily Grace Richardson with honors. Noah Daniel Robertson. Nishika Vimlish Shah with honors. John Alden Simmons. William Harrison Simmons, with honors. Emma Grace Stafford. Allison Paige Stallworth, with honors. Sloan Elizabeth Stewart. Morgan Kathleen Taylor. Autumn Riley Thomas. Daniel Noah Tidwell. Jonathan Brooks Toon, with honors. Ellen Sue Williamson, with honors. Zachariah Rashid Young. Let's give the 2022 graduates a round of applause. This time I'd like to invite Todd Elliott, father of graduate Zachary Elliott, to lead us in our benediction.
Let's pray together. God, we thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to be here today. And we come with so many different emotions. We are a little bit anxious, a little bit fearful, a little bit of sadness, but mostly we're grateful and we're thankful for these young men and women and the joy that they brought to our families, to our school for so many years. God, I thank you for the talents and the passions that you've given them. And God, I pray that you will bless them as they leave here today and as they embark on another chapter of their life. We pray that you will give them encouragement. We pray that you will keep them joyful. We pray that you'll keep them on task. And God, we pray that their dreams will come true. We pray that they'll always keep you at the center of their life. We pray that when the tough days come and they face challenges and have disappointments, that they'll always remember that you know their name, that you created them in your image, and that you love them dearly. Father, we pray that they'll always know that they have a place to come home to and people that will always be there for them. God, you give good gifts. And each of these 50 young people, we consider a gift. And we just want to thank you for them. And we look forward to the ways that you'll use them for your glory and your kingdom in the days to come. Thank you for Friendship Christian School, and thank you for the difference that it's been making in lives for many, many years. We pray that you'll bless the future of this great school, that it'll continue to carry on the mission of transforming lives and creating men and women who not only are prepared academically, but are prepared spiritually as well. Jesus, thank you for coming, living, showing us how to live, but most of all, dying in our place. And it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Todd. Appreciate that so much. This time I'd like to ask all of the candidate graduates to stand. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Graduates, you may move your tassels to the left. It is now my pleasure to present to you the FCS graduating class of 2022.